and get a preview of the game with the Stars play-by-play voice, Josh Bogorad. And Josh, four in a row for the Dallas Stars right now. What's clicking for this team? What's making it happen?
Well, it's certainly been the defense that's led the way. Four goals against in the four-game winning streak, and it's not hard to look any further than that. But also the way they're finishing these games. They're holding off on one-goal leads. They did that against Winnipeg and Buffalo. They got tie-breaking late goals in the last two victories at home against Minnesota, on the road in Nashville. And to be able to do that, to be able to win these tight games, that was really an area that the Stars struggled in. If you go back to about the midway point, late November, they were the worst team in the NHL statistically in games that were tied in the third period at any point. And now it's become a little bit of a strength, and they're showing they can play with the lead. They're showing they can get the lead late. They came from behind the other night in Nashville, and I think the way they're finishing these games says a lot about helping out the defensive end, which has certainly led the charge.
Yeah, being good in crunch time, that helps you in any sport. Certainly it helps you in this one. You mentioned the Stars blue line. They have done a really nice job of late. What's been some of the reaction to the defense's really strong play?
Yeah, it's really been from the goaltending out. And all year long, the goaltending has been exceptional. The goaltending from the get-go has been the strength of this team. Probably masked a lot of problems and kept the Stars above water, both Ben Bishop and Anton Khudobin. But now what you're seeing is, while the goals against remain down, it's also a collective team effort in front of the netminders. And I think that's maybe what makes the zeros and the ones and the twos that are getting posted now feel a little more different than the ones that were coming earlier in the year, because it's not asking your goaltender to stand on their head and make an abundance of saves on high-quality chances. The entire team, the defensemen, the lines in front of them, the forward group, they're all coming back. They're helping out. Even when the shots are high, for the most part, they're keeping teams outside. They're not giving up those quality opportunities. And now the sample size is large enough where this is a team that is a very good defensive team. They're second in team defense in the entire NHL for the season, and it's even better as of late. So they're very excited about what they're doing here defensively in this locker room.
Up front, since splitting up Jamie Benn and Tyler Seguin, the Stars have gotten better balance offensively. Why have things clicked so well since the change?
Yeah, maybe it's twofold. And if you look offensively, it has been spread out. On this four-game winning streak, seven different forwards have scored. And it might not sound like a lot, but the Stars really aren't scoring lately. So to spread it out is something that they weren't able to do. It took them 10 games right before this streak to get seven different forwards on the board. So that has helped. But then more than offensively, Jim Montgomery really likes the way his forwards are playing as units. And so Jamie Benn is playing with big, fast, good skating, hard bodies in Blake Como and Radek Foxa. And then you've got Seguin still with Radulov and Matthias Janmark. The bottom six forwards are able to roll and give you quality minutes. And the way it's spread out right now, Jim feels like it's four hard lines to play against. It's four lines that bring an awful lot of speed. They've injected that into their lineup with the trade for Andrew Cogliano and some of the recalls from the American Hockey League, and Roope Hintz and Denis Gurianov. And they really feel like now you can play any line. You're going to get a matchup you like because they're playing harder, they're more tenacious, they're quicker, and they like the balance. And so far, it's hard to argue.
Yeah, balanced scoring. Coaches like that. It usually works out well for you. Josh, thanks for the time today. We really appreciate it. Enjoy the game tonight.